Today I'm going to talk about how to make a double exposure in camera. Stick around to see how it's done, and why, and where you should might use it. Hi there, I'm Peter Forsgaard, an Olympus visionary and a professional photographer from Helsinki, Finland. And before we start getting into the how to make a double exposure in camera, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit that bell so you get notified when there is a new video online. My channel is all about you getting to be a better photographer and of course about Olympus gear. And remember, I post usually 2 videos a week. But let's start talk about multiple exposure. I came up with this idea a couple of weeks ago when I was going through my old images from way back 20. I went all the way back 20 years and I found this magazine, and here's the back of the magazine, and this is the whole spread that they used in the cover. And yes, this was a multiple exposure image done with Mamiya 6x7 medium format camera, and I think I used Fujifilm. It's either Provia or Velvia what I used back then. I can't really remember because I couldn't find the original slide that I have somewhere in my archives. But what's really interesting is that it was made in one shot. It actually had 6 times I exposed the same slide. So I did not advance the slide to the next one, and this is done only in camera. And that kind of image is a lot easier to make these days if you use Photoshop or any other image editing software. But that can also be done in camera today, with most of the cameras that are on the market, I think have the multiple exposure feature in it. But what's great about Olympus cameras are that every OMD camera has the multiple exposure feature built in. And as I said, if I make multiple exposure images these days, I will use Photoshop. I will tell you later why. The multiple exposure can be found in shooting menu 2. You just go to the multiple exposure and turn it on and choose 2F. And you're good to go. And then you take 2 images in a row and they will be composited in camera. And what's great about this method is that you can see the first image as an overlay when you take the second image. So it will make the composition a lot easier. And you will see from the viewfinder what the final image will look. At least almost what it's going to look. It looks a bit different, but you will learn when you use this how the image will come out. But as you can see, it's very easy to make multiple exposures with your Olympus camera. But there is a downside to this. You can only make actually double exposure. So multiple exposure is a bit over said on this feature. But in the end of this video, I will tell you how you can overcome this problem and use several images and make a composite and multiple exposure, a real multiple exposure. Let's say like 5 images. It can be done. And there are 2 ways of making multiple exposures with, or let's talk about double exposure for a while, with your Olympus camera. The first one is just to turn it on and take 2 images in a row. But there is another way of doing this also. You can use images that are on your memory card as an overlay or as a base image, which you will have a second image on top of that to be blended or making a composite. And those images need to be raw images. If you have a JPEG image in your memory card, you cannot use that one. But this is a very good way of making composite images or double exposures if the place that you are is not very close to each other. You can take other images in between and then come back and use that as a base when you find a certain or the place that you want to make the double exposure with a certain image that you're in your memory card. I think this is a very good feature. But there's one thing that I was a little puzzled about, because I tried to transfer an old image from my computer as a raw image back to the memory card, but it won't work. I don't know why. There must be something that the camera detects, and if that would be possible to take some old images and use those as overlay image, that would be great. But for now, you can only use images that are taken with the camera and not transferred from the computer to your memory card. So bear that in mind. But if you want to only take 2 images in a row, then you can use either RAW or JPEG. And the third option in the multiple exposure menu is auto gain. And using the auto gain, so turn it on, it makes it easier to expose. it makes a bit more natural image. Of course, natural image talking with multiple exposure. Well, that's, well, it is looking more natural. The exposure is easier to make with if you have the auto gain on. That's why I always recommend to have it on when using the multiple exposure feature in your Olympus camera. But where to use this feature? And when to use it? That's always a question. It's of course up to you if you want to do multiple exposure images and do something different, because I think it's a lot of fun. I've never done it that much in my Olympus camera, but since I started thinking about making this video, I realized how much fun this is actually to make these images, and it's a great feature in my opinion. And it's a great way to get creative, and if you never have tried it, please do. It's a lot of fun. And when you start making multiple exposure, there are a few things that you might consider. Try to have some black areas in the first image, some shadows or silhouettes or something like that, because then you take the second image and underexpose it a bit. You will see those, you will see the structures or the subject of the second image on the first image in the black areas more. So bear that in mind. If you have two really, really high-key or really light images, the effect isn't going to be very good. And it's always better to underexpose the second image a bit. It will show better blending with the first image. I hope this is clear, because I'm talking about the first image and second image. I might get lost in this, so please ask me in the comments down below if there's anything that is not clear, or I said it kind of funny, because it's actually quite hard to explain, even though it's a quite simple thing when you start using it. And as I said, silhouettes. If you have the first image, you have a silhouette, and then you take a second image, makes a great multiple exposure image, or as I said, double exposure in this case. And then the second very good thing is to add texture to your image. It's kind of like a overlay of texture in your image to make it, let's say you have a black and white image, and then you take a picture of some concrete wall and combine those two. You can make a really good structure or a really good surface on the image. And then of course you could use some bokeh balls on your images, like this one here. That's a double exposure in one of my videos that I think I did in November 2018, I think it was, where I had the image of a cup and then I had some lights in the background which were done so that I made them be out of focus and then made the overlay image. Overlay, I made the double exposure, and I think it gives and adds to the image quite a bit. And it's easy to do. Some other things to try when using multiple exposure. What if you zoom between the images? Let's take first image and then slightly zoom in or out and take the second image. You get a really nice ghost image. And always remember to experiment with the exposure, because you can always use the first image and then take the second one again if you need to. And bracket with the exposure, because the effect will be a bit different. And then what about you take first image is totally sharp and the second one you're slightly out of focus. And with this one also, experiment with the exposure and with the focusing distance. And you can also try the other way, take the first image out of focus and the next one in focus and see what that happens. It can make some pretty cool effects on your images. Move the camera a bit while you're making the exposure. Shaking the camera a bit during the exposure might give you some extra fine texture also on your image, or some wacky results. You never know. And that's what I like about this. Experiment and have fun. And then of course you can make totally abstract images also. See what the results are. They could be really nice. What are the downsides of, let's say, versus post-production? If you combine and make double exposure or multiple exposures in post, you have more control how much you can see the first or the other images. You can blend them differently. You can have different opacities on different places of the image, which is of course a different thing. But then you need to post-process image. If you want to do them in camera, you can. And then one thing, if you want to do post-processing and combine the images in let's say Photoshop, you need to take them separately. Because the multiple exposure feature won't record the individual raw images. It will only record the multiple exposure image in one raw file, if you use raw. Of course, if you use JPEG, then it will be JPEG. But you don't get two separate images and then the third one which is combined. I think what would be good that they really had the possibility to save the two individual raw files also, and then the combined image also. Then you could go back in Photoshop and maybe make it a bit better. If you see that the multiple exposure image wasn't that good, you could go back and tweak that. But maybe in a future models that will be possible. And before we get into the tip on how to combine more than two images in camera with your Olympus camera, I will tell you that I want to see your multiple exposure images. I will have a live show on 6th of September, and it's a Friday, and I will go through your images. So please send me your multiple exposure images. I will put all the details in the description of this video down below, so you know how to send those images, and send them by the 3rd of September. So I have a few days to check out those images, and I will go through those images and give feedback on a live show, as I said, on 6th of September. And the details on the live show will come to my channel later. So if you haven't subscribed yet and you want to see that, please do subscribe and hit that bell so you get notified when that video is going to be live. Most likely we'll not be able to cover all the images if I get tons of images, which would be nice. So I will pick the best ones to my live show, which will be about 1.5 to 2 hours long. And if I can cover all the images, then fine. But please send me those images. And as I said, the description below are all the instructions how to send your images. And now to the tip that I promised. How can you make a real multiple exposure images, and it's not only double exposure images? Well, it's actually quite easy. Well, first you just take a normally double exposure image, and then use that result as an overlay image and take the third one. And then if you want to take fourth one, use the third one as an overlay, fourth one, etc., etc. This way you can have as many overlays as you want in your image, or as combined as many images as you want. So that's how you get around the double exposure limit on your Olympus camera. And you might want to watch these videos next. But hey, thanks for watching, and bye for now. And please get those images coming. Instruction down below.